only the part that said we ain't making our quotas.
If only McDevitt's folk hadn't abandoned us, the cannery could use those extra hands.
Nothing we could... do about that?
Sure there is. We can have another zero-G. Had your rations yet?
Sorry, I'll just be a minute.
Hey, Colton, I'm going to be
the grease monkey, Argo?
Seems we've got a guest. Really now, Parvati, I do wish you'd spoken up. I do apologize. I was given no forewarning of your arrival, or I'm Reed Tobbs. I beg your pardon. I am most emphatically not keen on any... I can't let you have... There's a power regulator in the old botanic. Go down to the geothermal plant. Reroute power from the botanical district over to us. That's right. My hope is that by cutting off their power, you will convince those deserters to come back to town. Before you go to the plant, I want you to stop by the botanical lab. Speak to their leader, Adelaide. Tell her the power's about to go, and that it's time her band of deserters came back to town.
My dad told... I mean...
I hesitate to part ways with Miss Holcomb, but I cannot deny you will need an... Are you sure? You may find Miss Holcomb... Let's... start over. Walk me through the... process. Show me where it's going awry.
Well, sure. It's, most...
System. Processing. Investigating. Required for adjacent.
not real. You're not real. No, no, no. Just leave me alone.
Thank you.
momentum? You're not real. You're not real. Phantom! You're not real! You're not real! Get away from me, Phantom! Shoot! Scram! You can talk? The Phantom's never talked before. I knew I shouldn't have eaten that sprat raw. See? See, Higgins? This is why you must always boil your sprats before ingesting. Of course. Do excuse me. I experienced brief flashes of mania during which I am visited by the phantoms of my imagination. Chester D. Higgins. The D stands for definitely not insane. I use it as a reminder. Oh, Higgins has been many things over the years. Sprat Wrangler, Saltuna Critic, Aetherwave Personality, Chairman of the Board, Galactic Defender, Sisty Pig Tycoon. I've come a long way for someone who started off as a simple engineer right here in this plant. I specialized in automechanicals, drones, sentries, repaired them, maintained, upgraded, did it all from my old workroom just over in the next section. Mechanicals lost their bolts. Opened fire on anything that moved. It was pandemonium. You mean why did the mechanicals go on a murderous rampage? Same reason any of us do, I suppose. The voices told them to do it. I was on cleaning duty at the time. My old boss had me scrubbing pipes when the killing started. So, as usual, I missed out.
I put my whole life in that cannery.
Hiding in there?
Mr. Thompson is aware of your concerns and remains committed to guiding Edgewater.
You want to know what gets my bile churning? Edgewater has suffered a cavalcade of disasters. Plague, marauders, desertion. Then you wandered in town. And I was so damn sure our luck was starting to turn. I never knew how right I was. Just answer one question for me. Why'd you do it? That power regulator is company property. Whatever you were hoping to find down here, I advise you to turn around and leave. I have got guards posted with orders to fire on you.
Captain, what can I do for you, Captain? Do you know how to install a power regulator? Step 1, pick up your power regulator. Step 2, approach the terminal located in our engine room. Step 3, insert power regulator. Step 4, celebrate. All systems are operating within acceptable parameters. I am prepared to bring the Unreliable into low altitude orbit. This should prove an adequate test of our flight capabilities. A communication request. Please avoid damaging yourself or others while you're. The Groundbreaker. Remember that you are not insured.
That's not the point. This happened just not that.
Customs and inspection, right this way.
Identification, please. Captain Hawthorne, you said. Let me apologize in advance. I'm about to ruin your day. According to your ship's... You'll want to take it up. His office is located... Just the opposite. If I had to take a guess as to... You take the start... Oh, and if you're hit... Wanda Dorset. Much appreciated. Is there anything... Be seeing you.
I picked up this weird signal the other day. It was coming from Monarch.
Here we go again. No one lives on Monarch. It's a wasteland. You're hearing things.
No, seriously. There was a lot of static at first, but then this voice... Said his name was Graham?
Graham, right. Broadcasting on a dead world full of monsters. Now I've heard everything.
You know, it takes more muscles to frown than to... Smile.
Who told you that? Graham?
Vodka.
Sulfur rain are the least of the horrors plaguing the surface of Mono. anarchists live as one with the animals, lawless, savage, and unemployed. The board's embargo ensures that nothing can leave the place. You've been listening to Halcyon News, your mandated duty as a good citizen of Halcyon.
What was that? What was that? What? What do you think you're doing? What do you think you're doing?
What was that?
Did I hear?
What do you think you're doing? Huh?
What?
What was that?
Thank you.
go back to Byzantium.
Ah, yes. Wheeler messaged me you were coming. He must be the captain of the Unreliable, a vessel that used to be helmed by one Alex Hawthorne. And you are not he. Has something happened to my favorite scruffy freelancer? You have his ship. Ah, tell me. Right. There. I've removed the flag from your ship. I'm terribly sorry for the inconvenience. However, before you go, Alex promised to tell me the location of Phineas Wells. What? Indeed. And you know where he is? Excelsior! The thing... It's only temporary, of course. I'd never leave something so important in the hands of someone of... So you'll need to... Oh, my law. Now then, let me see. I just have to apply the seal here, sign like so, and... Ta-da! Here are the forms you'll need once you reach Byzantium. Oh, and a nav key so your ship can travel there. Those authorization forms will let you speak with Sophia when you arrive. I'll send her a message straight away to let her know you're coming. She'll be delighted, I'm sure. Best of luck to you, and thank you again. Give my regards.
Hey, you got a second?
Guess not.
Well, I did not expect you back so soon, Captain. Welcome back, Captain. How can I be of assistance? I have lots of minutes, many minutes, unlimited minutes, perhaps. I require a captain, arriving at Phineas's top secret orbital lab. We are now in orbit above Phineas, Captain.
Not so fast. All right, you're clear. The adjutant's expecting you. Go on. Thank you.
Not so fast. What do you think you're doing? What do you think you're doing? You take me for a fool! What do you think you're doing?
Nice doing.
Excuse me, just a moment.
Good afternoon. I'm Chairman Rockwell, and I'm here to address a serious issue facing us. As you all know, our colony has been successful beyond our wildest dreams. Unfortunately, we've recently discovered that our food supply will not be able to sustain Halcyon's population in the long term. Everyone will die. Everyone will slowly stop living from malnutrition. But we're doing it together. And that's what matters.
I fucking swear, if someone doesn't give me something to read that will placate the masses soon, all of you will find yourselves violently unemployed.
But I can assure you there's nothing to fear. We've got a solution. It's called the Lifetime Employment Program. We will freeze most of the colony to preserve resources, while the best and brightest of Byzantium continue living in prosperity.
Look, you idiots! How many times do I have to tell you we can't say shit like that? Fire whoever wrote this!
While Halcyon's brightest minds solve the problem of our nutritional shortage, the rest of the colony will be placed in suspended animation. Individuals will be revived on a rotating basis so that every Halcyonite can be part of the important work of saving our colony. By testing paperweights. Sorry, couldn't resist. Let's go again. And someday, in the not-too-distant future when we've solved this crisis, we'll all be back together again working for the good of Halcyon. Until then, the board shall provide for the deserving just as it always has. So, obey your supervisors, take your vitamins, follow your corporate-mandated grooming rituals, and rest assured with the board on your side, there is nothing to worry about.
Well, I did not expect you back so soon, Captain. You might want to clean your clothes more often.
Thank you. What? Thought I saw something.
So bring him down!
Thank you.
Huh? No visitors allowed, citizen. I'm gonna need to see some identification. Intruder!
Something's not... Huh?
What was that?
Something's not right.
Put him down!
Huh? What was that?
Here I come!
What?
Huh? Gotta get down! Here I come!
Huh?
Take him down! I'm reloading! Not so fast. The Ministry of Accuracy and Morale is off-limits to everyone without X-36 level clearance. Basically, if you don't work here, or for Chairman Rockwell himself, you're not getting in. I don't know how you got that, but I still don't know you, and I don't have any new clearances on the list. Intruder! No visitors allowed, citizen. No visitors allowed, citizen.
Well, I did not expect you back so... Welcome back, Captain. How can I be of assistance? What part of the colony would you like to discuss? Yes. As Dr. Wells is a wanted outlaw, he built his laboratory into an asteroid. Orbital destinations can be challenging to land on. His, more so than most. See you soon, Captain. Successfully arrived at Phineas's orbital lab, Captain, and we are still in one piece. Shall I congratulate myself, or would you like to do the honors?
Hello? Can you hear me? Does this work? I'm just securing my ongoing experiments. Executing my... Mind the mess. I haven't had a visitor since... In fact, I've never had a visitor.
Oh, thank the law. Your skin hasn't spontaneously changed color. Potential side effect of the revival process. Very rare, but you never know. Right. Welcome to my little habitation, such as it is. I've got caffeinoids, cysty bits, if you're into that sort of thing. So, welcome. Make yourself at home. My secret hideout. Not at all, my intrepid accomplice. I should thank you for tolerating my somewhat brusque manner. I only regret that I couldn't save more of your fellow settlers, what with being hunted by the board, and emptying my supply of necessary chemicals. Of course. What's on your mind? Absolutely. Let's talk. Oh, goodness, no. I wouldn't survive 10 seconds in the blackness of the Aether. Imagine I'd last at least 12 seconds before I'd lose consciousness and die of hypoxia. Life outside work? No, of course not. My life is my work. For that matter, everyone else's lives are also my work. An entire colony's worth of lives are at stake. It's up to me, up to us, to set things right. To answer your question, I'd rather stay right here in my lab. There's too much work to be done. The Hope's colonists won't revive themselves, you know. Remarkably well. After all, I managed to revive you without too many adverse side effects. We're even having a real conversation. That's progress. I still need your help, however. The sooner we discover the location of those chemicals, the sooner we can begin reviving the Hope's colonists. Get me those chemicals, and I'll revive the Hope. Revive the Hope, put a stop to the board. Stop the board, save the colony from destruction. Cause and effect. Simple, really. My progress is tied to your progress. We're in this together, my friend. Dimethyl sulfoxide is the missing ingredient, key compound, essential to reviving a long-frozen colonist. 10 years. That's how long the average human can remain in hibernation. You were frozen for decades. In theory, you never should have survived the revival process. But the conventional theories are wrong. You're living proof that it can be done. There's yet hope for the hope. Get it? We'll do our very best. I'd best... I hope you're not thinking of ingratiating yourself with the board. Rockwell and his cronies, they might tempt... What's up? Never know what being frozen did to your brain. There's always a chance you... I've no... Regardless... Absolutely. Let's talk...